security forces have a tough task at hand. After Home Minister's review meeting of the security situation, close to 7,000 troops are being rushed to Manipur. By the 30th of this month, about 5,000 boots from the CRPF and 2,000 additional ones from the Border Security Force will hit the ground. This will take the total number of paramilitary forces on the ground to more than 30,000. This includes ITBP, SSB, RPF, also BSF and CRPF. Now, while these forces on the ground, it's been assured, will be deployed evenly in the valley as well as in the hills, there's a lot of concern about whether this will lead to the results that the centre is hoping for. Now, we are told by officials that when the Home Minister reviewed the security situation in Manipur over the last 2 days, he specifically asked the central and the state government officials, the police officials, the paramilitary officials, as to how to restore peace. What is the idea that they have in mind for peace restoration? And Intelligence Bureau has been asked to come up with actionable intelligence so that if there is any attack, if you recall what happened in Jiribam on the 11th, is there was an attack from the Hamar tribe allegedly at the Thana, which was protected by CRPF. This Thana housed the Methi displaced people in a camp. Now, if there was specific intelligence available that the Hamar tribes, the villagers there were planning such an attack, perhaps preemptive action could have been taken. So instructions have been given to the Intelligence Bureau that you must give actionable input so that each of these planned conspiracies, planned attacks from either side can be preempted, they can be stopped before the conspiracy is hatched. On the other hand, there is also pressure on the CRPF specifically if they are deployed in the hillside. Because of what happened in Jiribam, CRPF not being a neutral force is what is being alleged by the tribals there. CRPF go back or CRPF not welcome. These kinds of placards have also come up in some areas, or they had come up earlier. In the valley, Imphal Valley, the challenges from the Kokovi and the Maiti groups who are putting up, posters saying that you must withdraw AFSPA. Now, the decision to bring in AFSPA was taken by the centre because of what happened in Jiribam. Now, that is backfiring because the Maiti groups are saying you must take back AFSPA. And if you don't do that, we will not allow central government officials to work. So yesterday, for example, there were some central government offices, including the State Election Commission office, that was also attacked by representatives who called themselves Kokomi supporters, and they forced some of the central government officials to get out of their office. So it's a tough challenge right now. We have not seen the cycle of violence come back. The NIA has taken over probe in the killing of the Hamar woman on the 8th and the subsequent violence that we saw on 11th. But the fact that there have been abduction of Methi women and children, some of their bodies have been found floating, has and plus AFSPA, these has heightened tension in the valley as well. The center is hoping the deployment of these security forces will resolve the situation. But former Home Minister P. Chidambaram has criticized this move as well. The Congress continuing to mount pressure, saying the answer is not in sending more forces, but to replace N. Biren Singh. And that is something that former ally Konard Sangma has also echoed. So a lot of challenges for the centre at the moment.